Hi students, so in this video we are going to focus in the concepts of functions. So first we will have the introduction of functions here. So before starting functions, we have to briefly discuss about Cartesian product, followed by relations, and then comes functions. Because before learning about functions, we have to discuss actually what is the definition of this Cartesian product, what is mean by a relation, and then we will go to functions, because all these are interlinked. Cartesian product. So Cartesian product, for defining this, let me take two sets. So let me take A comma B are two sets. So I'll take set A as A, B, C, set A having elements A, B, C, and I will take set B having elements 1, comma 2. Now the Cartesian product from A to B is defined as A cross B. This is the symbol we use. Cartesian product from A to B is denoted with this symbol, A cross B. We will actually read it as, and is defined as, A cross B contains all the ordered pairs of the model x comma y such that x belongs to set A and y belongs to set B. So this A cross B, or Cartesian product from A to B, contains all ordered pairs of this model, where first element comes from this first set A. You have to take in order. First element comes from this first set A, and second element comes from second set B. So all possible ordered pairs you can write using first element from set A and second element from set B will be contained in A cross B. Now what is ordered pair? So ordered pair we have already discussed in geometry part. So this X is called as the first coordinate or the first element or first component, where Y is called as the second element or second component. Second coordinate also we can read. So how can we write the set of all these ordered pairs? So first element coming from set A means in place of X, I can use A or B or C. Second element coming from set B means in place of Y, I can use 1 or 2. So therefore I can write the different ordered pairs like this. A comma 1 I can write, A comma 2. So in place of X, I can use A or B or C. In place of Y, I can use 1 or 2. Okay, so we can write B comma 1, B comma 2. We can write C comma 1, C comma 2. So these many ordered pairs in different models we can write. So this is the Cartesian product from A to B. Okay, now similarly, we can write the Cartesian product from B to A, denoted as B cross A. Now, B cross A means it contains all ordered pairs of this model, where the first element comes from set B now. So, first element comes from set B means either 1 or 2 you have to write. And second element comes from set A. Second element must be either A or B or C. So different order space we can write. So first element coming from B, second element coming from A. So we can write 1 comma A, 1 comma B, 1 comma C. You can write 2 comma A, 2 comma B, 2 comma C. Now clearly you can see A cross B, B cross A have different ordered pairs. A comma 1 is different from 1 comma A, clearly both are not same. So A cross B need not be same as B cross A. A cross B, B cross A, they need not be equal or same. So number of ordered pairs is actually same in both of them, but the ordered pairs are different. We can define Cartesian product from A to A like this. Cartesian product from A to A, denoted as A cross A. Now, when I am taking A cross A, the ordered pairs must have first element coming from A and second element also coming from A. Means first element coming from these three elements, second element also coming from these three elements. So I can write like this. I can write A comma A, first element A or B or C, second element also A or B or C. So I can write A comma B, A comma C, B comma A, B comma C, B comma B. I can write C comma A, C comma B, C comma C. Total 9 ordered pairs we got. So I can define B cross B also. Cartesian product from B to B. So first element or first coordinate coming from set B. Second coordinate coming from set B. First and second coordinates both coming from B. That means both coming from elements 1 or 2. So I can write ordered pairs like this. 1 comma 1, 1 comma 2, 2 comma 1, 2 comma 2. So these are the different Cartesian products we can define when we take two sets A and B like this. Now, this A cross B has how many elements? 6. B cross A, you have again 6 elements. A cross A, 9 elements we got. B cross B, 4 elements we got. Now let us define the number of elements. Number of elements in A cross B is simply n of A into n of B. That's it. And n of A is nothing but the number of elements in set A. 3. N of B means number of elements in set B. 2. So 3 into 2, 6. That is what we have here. So n of A is the cardinal number of A. N of B is the cardinal number of B. So this is 3, this is 2. So 6 is your answer. Number of elements in B cross A. It is simple. N of B into N of A. So N of B 2, N of B 3. Again you will get 6. Number of elements in A cross A is N of A into N of A, which will be 3 into 3, 9. In B cross B, number of elements, N of B into N of B, which gives us 2 into 2, 4. So this is the formula to find the number of elements. Simply, number of elements in first set multiplied with number of elements in second set. This is the number of elements in the Cartesian product. Okay. Now, using Cartesian product, we will try to define a relation. Now, what is a relation? The basic definition of relation is, if I take Cartesian product of A cross B, any subset taken from this will be called as a relation from A to B. Any subset taken from Cartesian product from A to B is called as a relation from A to B. Any subset taken from B cross A is called as a relation from B to A. Any subset taken from A cross A will be called as a relation from A to A. Or we can simply say binary relation on A. Binary relation on A and simply relation on A. any subset taken from this. Now any subset taken from B cross B is called as a relation from B to B, or a binary relation on B, or simply relation on B. So relation is basically a subset of the Cartesian product. It is from A to B or B to A, depends on the different Cartesian products we are taking. Okay, so now let us consider the different forms of relations that which we can write here. So okay, let us discuss one by one. So if I take this Cartesian product A cross B, any subset of this is called as a relation. Now relations generally we denote with capital R. So I will define a relation like this. Any subset you can take. And what is a subset? Subset is a part of this. Okay, so any subset means I can take like A comma 1, like A comma 2. So this is subset of, this is clearly a subset of A cross B. So it can be called as a relation. So I can define one more. Like I can write A comma 2, B comma 2, C comma 2. Now even this is a subset of A cross B, because all these elements are contained in A cross B. This is clearly a subset of A cross B. So this can be taken as a relation. So like that, any subset taken from A cross B becomes a relation. So how many relations we can define from A to B here? We know that if a set has n elements, if a set has n elements, then the number of subsets of that set is 2 power n. Set has n elements means number of subsets corresponding to that set will be 2 power n. Now this A cross B has how many elements? This A cross B has n of A into n of B number of elements. So this is actually number of elements in A cross B. Number of elements in A cross B, we know the figure. And how many subsets you can form using this? So if A cross B has these many elements, the number of subsets we can form from A cross B using this formula becomes 2 power n of A cross B. A cross B has these many elements. So number of subsets we can take from A cross B means 2 power n of A cross B. That means 2 power n of A into n of B. This is the total number of subsets formed using A cross B. And relation is also a subset. Because relation is called as a subset of A cross B, how many subsets we can form using this is same as number of relations. Number of relations formed is same as number of subsets of A cross B. So this will be the number of subsets or number of relations defined from A to B. I just wrote some examples. This is a subset. This is a subset. So these two are relations defined from A to B. So if I take a subset from B cross A, it will be termed as a relation from B to A. If I take a subset from A cross A, it will be termed as a relation from A to A. So based on which Cartesian product we are using, we will get the relations. So basically this is the formula. If you are using A cross A, number of relation becomes 2 power n of A into n of A. 2 power n of A into n of A will be number of relations if you are using this Cartesian product. So basically this is the formula for number of relations which we have to remember. Now let us discuss some more elements or some more examples based on these relations now. So for example, a comma 1 is an ordered pair which is in this relation. So instead of R1, I will write R here. So a comma 1 belongs to R, means a comma 1 is an element in this relation. Then we can write A is related to 1. We can write like this. A comma 2 is an element in this relation. So A comma 2 belongs to R. We can actually write this as A is related to 2. Means there will be some relation between first element and second element. What is the relation connecting these two is defined by this relation. Means first element and second element are connected by some relation. That is what is defined by this. Now what is the relation connecting them can be defined in different ways. For example, so different ways we can use. For example, now let us take a different example. I'll take set A as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I will take set B as 2, 3, 4, 5, 8 for example. Now I will define the relation R as, R contains all ordered pairs x comma y such that x belongs to A, means x comes from first set, y belongs to B, the second coordinates come from second set such that x is less than y. Now what is the relation connecting the first coordinate and second coordinate here? This is the relation. So when x is less than y, that ordered pair comes into this relation. This relation contains all ordered pairs satisfying this condition. So this is the connection between the first and second coordinates. So I can write like this also. X is related to y if and only if x is less than y. I can write like this also. So how we get the relation now? See carefully. So what are the ordered pairs we can write here? See carefully. So first coordinate must be less than the second coordinate. So I can write 1 comma 2. X less than y is satisfied here. And I can write 1 comma 3. I can write 1 comma 4, 1 comma 5, 1 comma 8. Now starting from 2, I can write 2 comma 3, 2 comma 4, 2 comma 5, 2 comma 6 is not there, 8. Now 3 comma 4 I can write, 3 comma 5 I can write, 3 comma 8 I can write, 4 comma 5 and 4 comma 8. Okay, so 5 comma 8. All these ordered pairs satisfy this relation. So first coordinate must be less than the second coordinate is the relation given here. Like that in any relation, between first and second coordinates, there will be some connector. That connector is actually the relation. So I can define this relation as, I can give like x greater than y also I can give. So every ordered pair satisfying this condition, will be in the relation. So first coordinate must be more than second coordinate is the condition given here. And that itself is the relation between first and second coordinates. So this is the basic thing you have to understand here. So how the relations will be defined. So I am taking Set A as 1, 2, 3, 4. Set B as A, B, C, D. X, Y is an ordered pair in the relation if X is related to Y. X is related to Y means some condition will be there. So, I am taking the relation like this. So, relation has ordered pairs like this. So, we have to always remember that the set of all first coordinates will be called as domain of this relation. Set of all first coordinates will be called as domain. And set of all second coordinates will be called as range of the relation. And we can also write the ordered pairs in terms of mappings like this. So you can see that the set A has elements 1, 2, 3, 4 and set B has elements A, B, C, D. So here 1 is related to A. I can say like this. 1 is related to A. We can also define that as 1 is mapped to A. So 1 is related to A is same as 1 is mapped to A. 1 is related to B also, or 1 is mapped to B like this. And 1 is mapped to A. Relation R is the operator here. So this relation is collecting the elements. So this is termed as operator, or this is the operator which is collecting the elements from set A to set B. So 2 is related to B. That means 2 is mapped to B. 3 is related to C, or 3 is mapped to C. 4 is related to B. 4 is related to D. So we can write the mappings like this. So one element is related to another element is same as one element is mapped to another element. The set of first coordinates will be called as domain, which we have taken as this first set here. And the set of all second coordinates will be called as range. Now elements of domain will be mapped to elements of this codomain. So if we are writing the relation R from A to B, this is the terminology we will be using here. Relation R is defined from A to B can be written like this. The relation R defined from A to B. This A is called as domain of the relation, whereas B is called as codomain. B is not the range. Remember, B is codomain. Set of all second coordinates will be called as range. So set of all second coordinates will form range, but not directly B. That means, for example, if I take out this mapping, or if I take out this element here, you can see that set of all second coordinates means only A, B and C will come. This D will not come. So codomain means B only, but range will be A comma B comma C. That is the basic difference between codomain and range. Range will be A, B, C only, because set of all second coordinates means you will get A, B, C only, because B is actually not mapped to anything in A. So this is called as range, whereas codomain means B only. So based on these mappings, or based on these relations, different types of relations based on mappings we can take. Different types of relations, let us discuss about the different types of relations.